I was tracking Charlie Buckley's life pretty well. He graduated, got married, got a job selling ad space in a magazine called Business Sense, had a kid, then 6 months ago, the whole family gone, professionally erased.
How professionally?
Pretty damn professional.
He didn't do it himself.
No, this is the kind of thing a big law enforcement agency does. We could do it, a big criminal organization could do it, possibly even high-level hackers.
So everything's erased?
Everything except for a 17-year-old bank account, which hasn't been touched in all that time.
Maybe he forgot about it?
Not 40 grand he didn't. The guy sells advertising in a magazine.
Put a flag on it. They may have erased his name and numbers, but they can't clean everything.
I don't know, they were pretty thorough.
Yeah, but there are some things you can't erase, like a man's health.
Charlie Buckley's medical records are long gone.
True. But check the records of the pharmacies located near his last known address. One of them should have his prescription.
You were right. Here are his prescriptions. That's for high cholesterol. That's for a pretty rare thyroid problem. Oh, we have the friendly blue pill. Viagra. And, oh, wait a minute. We might have gotten lucky here. Let me double check this beta histine. That's what I thought, beta histine. It's an experimental drug. Charlie has Meniere's disease.
What is that?
It's an inner ear disorder. It's pretty harmless, really. It just makes you dizzy.
Takes a lot of prescriptions.
That thyroid prescription is very unusual. The beta histine is pretty rare, and if we put them together, I bet we got a profile.
Search your drugstore databanks. See if anyone else is using that combination of medications.
Okay, we have three hits. 71 years old, no. Vietnamese name, no. That leaves this one, and the winning pharmacy is located right down the street, Bloomington, Indiana.
So there was no trace at the Bloomington bus or train station? What about the municipal airport?
Nothing.
Okay, check private airports, heliports, used car lots. Sunny.
Thanks, Jeff.
Something the matter?
No, nothing at all. Nothing at all except for the fact that I cannot track Charlie Buckley because all that stuff has been erased. And if he left voluntarily, he's not traveling under the name of Don Halliday. So essentially, I'm trying to find a guy who has no identity.
Okay. Let's use that to our advantage. Now, he has to use cash for everything. Does that get us anywhere?
Yes, you're right. Thank you.
Okay. Hey, I had a dream. It was about...
See you on Friday.
Friday. Bye.
Has this fax got anything to do with you? Business school class list of Notre Dame 1995?
Thank you, Sonny. Where's Jess?
She's down the hall.
Tell her we have to go back to Bloomington.
Sonny, you got anything for me?
Nothing since you last asked me 7 minutes ago. You're pent up, you know that?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I do know that.
It's hard when it's personal.
It's not personal, Sonny.
Oh, no, you're just doing your job in your usual pent-up way.
Okay, could you do that?
Do what?
Just walk out of the house with your wife in danger.
If I was motivated.
Motivated by what?
Something just as important.
What could be that important?
I don't know, but if we find it, I bet we find Charlie Buckley.
I bet you we do.
Okay, now, do you know anything about access codes for mass online sweeps of security net footage?
No.
Then maybe you should make room for someone who does.
She's running out of time. Hazlitt.
Hey, it's Sunny.
Sunny, give me some good news.
Do you remember that bank account? The one that hadn't been touched in 17 years?
Yeah.
Well, it's been touched.
Really?
A check cleared on that account made out to a Lowell Manx of Sacramento, California.
Mary, Sacramento mean anything to you?
Charlie sold ad space for Business Sense. He covered that area.
We have a bogey out here.
Copy.
Call me back with an address. You got something?
Maybe. We have a piece of surveillance video of Charlie in a bus station 2 days ago. The facial recognition software says there's a 50% chance that it's him.
Where was it taken?
Sacramento.
It's gotta be him.
Yeah, but this is the weird part. He's waiting in line, he gets all the way to the front of the line, and then he takes off without buying the ticket.
Which he would do if he thought someone was watching him.
Hey, guys. I know whose birthday party it is.
Whose?
It's mine. My 7th birthday.
We'll talk about it on the plane. Come on.
Where are we going?
To see the guy Charlie wrote the check to.